This is an emergency use vaccine. So what can it do? What is the sort of worry that people had in taking the vaccine, which you articulated very well? Amongst the people who live on a daily wage, the worry is different. Even innocuous side effects like fever or body pain, for them makes a difference because it could mean 1 or 2 days of wages lost. So what we need to do in this transparent effort is, how do you support them if there is a situation where they have to be off work? How do we support them? We have given free rations to so many people. This could be an opportunity. Instead of making it mandatory, then the hesitancy can increase. If you are looking at what Mr. Trudeau faced yesterday, when he was asking people to be compliant with COVID protocols, there was a big backlash. In France, we've seen Macron have a backlash. The moment, even masking, if you make it mandatory, there would always be 15-20% who would resist that, whether on misbeliefs or whether on a political ideology. So mandating something just for the sake of it may not work. But looking at incentivizing vaccination is another different way of doing it. So you're not mandating or not forcing or penalizing. You're saying, if you do this, if you wear a mask every day, come to the office regularly with your mask, and others respond saying that, yes, this person has worn the mask regularly, I will see to it that I give you one extra day off. Now, that's an incentive. It need not be monetary, but it could be something which appeals to people. Or I could give you tickets to go to, Wonderla Resort or something like that. Make it interesting for people to accept with transparency. Mandating always has negative consequences. We've seen with the lockdown, and I completely agree with what Dr. Vidyasagar Garu said about Kerala. The same thing when we had the lockdown. So you were pushing it back because the country was not prepared with that sort of an infrastructure, so it was required at that time. But that is not a requirement right through. Kerala, if you look at, I worked at AIIMS for 30 years before moving here. Every year, we used to have a small outbreak of chickenpox. 100% of them used to be the nursing students from Kerala who come to AIIMS to do their BSc nursing. Not one single chickenpox case amongst nurses or doctors who come from the rest of the country. That is, the level of hygiene, the level of awareness, as long as they are within that bubble in Kerala, they were safe. The minute they came, got exposed to a cold climate, because chickenpox, the virus, just the winter and early spring is when it starts transmitting. In Kerala, you don't have winter or early spring. So they were never exposed to the virus. If you had mandated chickenpox virus vaccine before joining the nursing course, it would have worked, because the incentive was to join that professional program.
That's a fantastic point. Actually, incentivization actually makes the vaccine hesitancy less. I think there are n number of publications about that in public health, that how counterproductive is to mandate something. I think a point very well made. Just to, as a follow-up, very inquisitive about one thing, that we see even among healthcare workers, the vaccination as of now is, as per various statistics, which we have, is not actually crossing that needle of 65-70%, right? And these are the people who are supposed to be providing the care, right? And there is always a possibility that they are going to harm their clients, or, in some cases, we don't call them as patients, either patients or the clients of that particular institution. How do you go about them? Is it going to be more ethical, actually, to mandate at least the healthcare workers in order to allow them into the care?
Okay, I'll just take that point about mandating once again. If you mandate that everybody in the health workforce should get it done, I can go and we know how our the vaccination certificates were generated. Our RT-PCR tests are not accepted when you travel because they think that you've just paid 400 rupees. We saw that in the Kumbh Mela, where people got false certificates. What is it that prevents somebody from taking distilled water or not taking distilled water also, just coming with a certificate, which is much more harmful? So creating that awareness on why that is required, also telling them, a lot of people believe that things like Chyawanprash can prevent infection. There are many, you know, they come from Uttarakhand, some products are made there, I won't name the persons. But people think if you drink one portion every day in the morning, you will not get it. There are people in Andhra Pradesh who have been distributing that wonder medicine, saying that, okay, this will prevent you. So you have to fight those myths if you have to reduce hesitancy. That this is the benefit, like Dr. Mukherjee mentioned. If you take the vaccine, 10 times lesser number of deaths compared to person who have taken the vaccine. Health insurance, which the Prime Minister organized, you know, for health, every health provider, if you are, because if you die as a part of COVID duties, we'll give you a compensation. Now that you can tie up, that only if you're vaccinated, would you get that. So that is, that becomes an, it is an ulterior motive, I agree, but that is one way. That 100% mandating is, you bring in more fraud cases happening rather than making it really good.